Stop being foolish, playing his game. Stop allowing people to come up with these cameras and tell you all kind of dumb shit that has nothing to do with your survival. You want the woman to have babies without a man? She's God. Should we have a black woman? I mean, all of this is retarded shit. Why you keep rehashing over things that we've answered 50 years ago?
What's happening, fam? Now, I've been wanting to touch on this subject for quite a while, man. And the reason why I didn't touch on it when it first came out was because I'm the type of person that I don't like to cover current events and topics when it hits right away. I like to get all the information disseminated first and then later on touch back on the topic. As we all are, well, the controversy surrounding Brother Polite and his alleged sexual assault case with a 14-year-old girl, and it has caused so many people to basically berate him from a public point of view. Now, I'm not saying that you're wrong in that, but I think we need to shed a little bit more light into the conscious community. I truly believe many people have this misconception of what the quote-unquote conscious community really is. And the reason why I say that is because many people view certain figures that have risen to popularity online or out here as a public figure, and they consider them to be leaders of black people. And to me, that is a huge mistake most of our people do in regards to the Brother Polites or the Umar Johnsons or the Young Pharaoh. First and foremost, none of these men are leaders. They do not have their own government, their own nation, their own land, their own organization, and they're not even leaders in their own neighborhoods or community. So we have to stop with this nonsense of looking for one black person to save us. We have to stop with this savior-like complex figure. First and foremost, what constitutes the conscious community? Because I've been quote-unquote conscious for about close to 20 years. And when I came into knowledge of self, which in fact is the true meaning of what you would call the conscious community. Knowledge of self just means you have come across some studies and some teachings that help raise your consciousness of who you are, that allows you to elevate into being a more refined and spiritually enlightened and positive-minded person. That is the true meaning of a person being conscious. A conscious person ain't someone that just studied about Egypt and changed his name to Amun-Ra. Now all of a sudden he's quote-unquote conscious. No, your actions, thoughts, and behaviors constitutes as a result of you gaining this new form of knowledge of self. And once you have developed this knowledge of self based off of your actions, then you will have the capacity to enlighten and teach others and help them on their journey as they gain a new sense of who they are. This is what the conscious of the quote-unquote conscious community really stands for. You're not going to go in no sector of any black neighborhood in America and find this one small segment that's called the conscious community. That does not exist in the United States of America at all. Just because someone speaks with some form of intelligence or they sound articulate doesn't mean that they extract themselves from the rest of black people. Now, once again, the actions of these brothers, if they are guilty, they should be condemned and absolutely shunned from black people, period. Because we should not tolerate any forms of pedophilia, sexual abuse, sexual assault, sexual violence, murder, betrayal, and dissent against black people, and especially against children. We shouldn't tolerate that at all. But until the final results are in, we should not be condemning people just to get favor in the court of public opinion. I'm not saying neither one of these brothers or what they did is innocent or guilty. What I'm saying is, stop putting them on this level that they represent the whole entire quote-unquote conscious community.
You've demasculined the black man to the point to where he comes to a lecture to hear another nigga tell him about which woman he should have. She don't need you because she can have babies without you. Well, I ain't never seen a woman have no damn baby without no man.
Teach that truth.
They talking all of that Yang shit. The white man don't even get on TV and tell you this dumb shit.
And one aspect of why these guys have risen to their levels of position is because of their internet fame and popularity. Because someone can elaborate themselves very clearly. They can articulate themselves very thought out with their words or their choice of their vocabulary. Just because they know how to flip words and it sounds so good that you can't believe that they were able to master the notion of the English language via through the dictionary, does not mean that they are leaders of our people. And another thing that has really turned me off about a lot of these people in the quote-unquote conscious community is the debating aspect of it. One reason why I never got into Sonetta was because you have all these different groups and all of these different ideologies, and you're bringing them together to go against each other. And by them going against each other, each one of these different groups are trying to convince the other group that their ideology works best or better than their ideology. All it does is automatically cause division. Because if I can't express my point of view without you feeling offended and vice versa, then why are we out here having these debates amongst each other in the first place? Contrary to popular belief, every black person isn't going to follow Egyptology. They're not going to be red, black, and green. They're not going to be RBG. They're not going to be Moors. We have to understand the true nature of what our people currently are dealing with here in America. The vast majority of black people in this country are Christian, at least over 80 to about 85%. So we're dealing with black people who subscribe to a Christian ideology. And most of them are not going to go against that concept. They believe more in Christ than they believe in Allah, Jah, Buddha, Yahshua, all that, man. So these concepts of a lot of these conscious groups that go against religion, but yet they do the same thing that they accuse the church and the mosque of doing. At least in the church, they get things done. At least in the church, they can do something on behalf of the community. A lot of these conscious guys, they collect money and donations the same way the Christian church does. They get tax write-offs the same way the Christian church does. And then a lot of them take off with the money in the same manner in which a lot of these corrupt Christian preachers do. But yet, they are so against religion. One thing I've also noticed in regards to a lot of these conscious guys, they heavily criticize religion. Many of them are immoral. That is the number one reason why a lot of these conscious guys go against religion. If your thing is loving your people and having a race first philosophy, why does it matter whether or not a person's religion should form your conclusion on whether or not you want to love and embrace that person? If you know this guy is a Christian and you invite him to a meeting, and then as soon as he comes into the meeting, you're totally desecrating or just attacking Christianity, how you think you make that person feel, man? You make that person may never come back into your meeting. Now, if you had a conversation with your brother on his beliefs and you like, brother, I understand you believe in this, but this is something that I've researched and what I've learned, he may feel different about it. He may want to learn about your point of view. This is what turns people away from the quote-unquote conscious community. It's the vice of going into the door. Does that take away from people who have a thorough knowledge of self? No, because there are many people with a knowledge of self who are in black-ran organizations that are actually doing work the right way on behalf of the people. Only difference is they're on a very small scale. they have smaller numbers, so they're unrecognizable to the large masses of our people. Whereas you got young pharaohs and Sarah Sue Settys and Umar Johnsons and Professor Grissom, all these people are well known. Another factor of what turns people away from the conscious community is there's a lot of corruption and scams going on. That's what got Brother Polite in trouble amongst the people in the first place. Young Pharaoh, same thing. Umar with the whole school situation, which he has buildings, but he still hasn't opened that school. In my personal opinion, Umar should have started small and built his way up. But I digress.
Personally, I don't think this community that they call conscious is all that conscious. Because look at the list of shit that has been debates. And honestly ask yourself, do any of that shit make sense?
When you're scheming your own people out of their own hard-earned money, you're just no different than the cracker who you claim to be your enemy. You think just like your enemy. So you're even a further detriment to your own people when you rob and trick your people out of their hard-earned money. But in some ways, some of our people kind of deserve to get tricked, because nobody told you to spend your money with them anyway. They have to prove their merit and their worth to you before you start calling them a leader. None of these guys are leaders. We have to stop looking for a savior complex as if one black person is going to lead the masses of our people. That has never happened in history. And finally, what is the conscious community actually producing that is going to get the younger people to go along with what it is they're presenting? Because I can tell you right now, being at a storefront, being on the corner, speaking that knowledge, speaking that science, that ain't cutting it with the vast majority of these youth. Selling incense oil, laundry detergent, toilet paper, toothpaste and all that ain't gonna cut it, man. What we need to totally focus on as a people is to own industries and infrastructures. Once we can get a grasp of that and totally own that, then you will start to lure the younger people into wanting to get into that expertise or that field. In other words, I give you an example. Let's say you from the block, right? And all of a sudden, you don't want to be on the block no more. You don't want to kick it. But you get a trade, or you go into a field to where you can actually own something. A trade such as technician, electrician, an IT specialist, a construction worker, a truck driver. These are fields that most of our people can make real good money from. But you have to be able to show that to the young person. So if you're an electrician and you earn anywhere between $70,000 to $85,000, $90,000 a year, and you got a crib and you're riding something clean, what you think a young person gonna look at? They're gonna be like, man, how do I get that? And if you already got knowledge yourself, this is how you'll be able to introduce that young person to knowledge yourself. Just standing on the corner, standing on the block with a bum ass building and a dingy looking storefront and wearing dashikis and a kufi ain't gonna cut it. Because they already think you soft in that regard, which is furthest from the truth. However, the perception of what these young people look at, many of us who call ourselves conscious, they think that we ain't about nothing. Why? Because we ain't producing anything in regards to industries and infrastructure. Let's say I'm conscious and I'm an artist. I own my own music. Guys, I've been counting. I've never told them to sign to no label. I always told them, look, I'm an independent artist and I can show you how to do it to where you earn your own money, you retain ownership of your own music, and you can, through your hard work, your perseverance, you'll be able to generate income literally just being asleep. That's consciousness right there. I just informed another young brother or a young sister on doing something productive for self. This take away from the valuable work many of our brothers and sisters who are enlightened do? Nope. Because as I stated earlier, There are many people who call themselves conscious. They are doing right on behalf of our people. However, they do not get the publicity they deserve because they're only a selected few that have that type of internet fame or that strong social media presence that will get more popularity than them. And so the work that they do, it goes under the radar. It doesn't even get brought up nor recognized. But the guys that has the money and the fame, they are perceived as being the conscious community. They're only a small segment of it. They do not represent conscious people as a whole. They only represent one element of the conscious community. Only difference was they were able to take the knowledge and the information they received and do it at a much bigger level. But they still only did it for self, because look at some of the scandals and some of the atrocities attached to their name. Can you really say they conscious? Or did they just con you out of your money, your resources, and your time? So in closing, this theme about the conscious community, if you're looking only at internet figures to get your reality of what the conscious community really is, you're not getting nothing conscious about that at all. If you're seeing brothers and sisters actually out in their actual lives doing the real work in form of our people, educating our people, helping our people, uplifting our people, that is the true concept of what being an enlightened or conscious person really is. Not following figures just because you're looking for a leader. The only way black people are going to excel in terms of leadership is by a collective entity of wise, enlightened, intelligent, and dedicated and sincere brothers and sisters. Collective. If not, no one leader is going to work, not only for black America, but for melanated people across this planet. That's my take on the conscious community. If they are out here doing wrong by the people, condemn them, because they deserve to be ostracized and shunned from our people. But stop believing in the false notion that the conscious community is a sham. Just because a few people out here are robbing our people, they do not represent for the entire masses of our people who have a thorough knowledge of self. Peace and love. May God bless each and every last one of you. 100.
Everybody wants to be the star. And I hope they be stars. But the reality of this is that, yes, sir, ain't none of y'all gonna shine for long. You're gonna make some money. You're gonna have your car, your house, a little notoriety. But like a star, which is a dying planet, that flickering light, your ass is going out because you have sold out.